it is very clear that inside the courtroom, the petitioners did not even have the conviction to press their petition. And therefore, after being confronted with uncomfortable questions, they decided to withdraw the petition. Even more unfortunate is the part that lawyers who file petitions do not argue it within the courtroom. Rather, after orders are passed and judicial pronouncements are made, they come out of the court and then they cast aspersions on the judiciary and they make lengthy arguments before the media.
See, it's very unfortunate that the court has refused to even give a copy of the administrative order by which this matter was referred to a constitutional bench. I mean, it's obvious that the Chief Justice must have done it by an administrative order, where in a case which directly involves the Chief Justice, so he could not have dealt with it at all.
I, as a litigant, have the right to be made aware of what is that order, who has passed it, in what circumstances, and what is the tenor of that order? And how can a person be denied a copy of an order which is passed on the administrative side? That's a fundamental question that has to be answered. In fact, there is no judgment in the history of the Supreme Court where on the administrative side, a matter has been referred to five judges, and we don't know how that matter has been referred to five judges.